Okay. Guys, welcome in. Here's our June mobility, mindful mobility class. You'll need today a band or a towel or a yoga strap would work perfectly for any of those. And also a chair. I'm going to be using the Pilates Reformer today for a chair to sit down, minimizing equipment, doing it anywhere. So here we go. We're going to start standing. So I'd like you to just grab your band or your yoga strap and then just take a little twist side to side, right? As you rotate, you're going to let your legs be really free here. And you can see in that mirror behind me, my heels are lifting up. Trying to strategically pick this spot so you could see all angles. And then go ahead and hold to one side. Now you're going to drop your band down towards the floor. There's a little bend in your knees there. And then reach it up and around. So you know that camera kind of cuts off that angle, but it's just an up and around and down. A big open circle there. We'll go two more in this direction. Sometimes this is called sundial pose in yoga. Just holding that band, towel, or strap. Let's go other side here. You're gonna drop down into the right and then up into the left or reverse of what you did. Give your knees a really good bend here. Open up. I feel really nice here on a Wednesday, smack in the middle of your day, your week. Ah, let's go one more here. Good, now stretch up, just hold up and then drop the band down. Do that again. You're gonna lift up, stretch up, maybe look up so you can see the band. Come on down. This absolutely can be done seated in your chair too. If you have limited space, look up, reach up. And then come on down. Let's do that two more times. Lift up, stretch up. And then exhale, come on down. Let's do that one more time. Stretch up, reach up. And then come on down. If you're seated, go ahead and stand up. You can drop that band off to the side. Make it a roll your shoulders for me. I'm gonna take this off so you can, it looks so sloppy. And roll your shoulders a couple times. Up, back, and down. Up, back, and down with the shoulders. Yeah, now I want you to roll your shoulders up, forward, and down. Just really get the upper joint of the arm moving. Roll. Good, and then now you're gonna land it right in the center. You're gonna roll your shoulders forward and then back. Open the palms as you do that. So roll them forward, protraction of your shoulder blade. And then roll wide, turn your palms wide. Maybe even feel some like snap, crackle, pops there. The bicep opens up, shoulders, pecs, there's a lot going on there. Good, you do that one more time. Palms in, palms wide. Now you're gonna interlace your hands behind your back. Drop your knuckles down and then a simple extension. Yeah. Lift your heart, ooh, lift your chest. Good, now come down to neutral. I'm gonna give you a couple options here. It could be a full body, could be a full forward fold where you let your head and your shoulders drop down, maybe hands move away from your body. You could also grab your strap and do the same thing as you fold forward, right? Let the strap, let the towel take your shoulders. You could also take your hands to your chair and let yourself just dangle forward, okay? So many positions that you could take there. It's just a forward fold. So take what you need. Yeah. And let that feel really good. Let your body just kind of turn upside down for a moment. I like this one with the band up and over. Good, and wherever you are here, before you come up, I'd like you to release your hands, whether they're in that interlace or you have your strap or your band, drop that. Take your hands down either to your chair or just let them dangle. And then we're gonna get together here. You're gonna take a nice inhale breath. And as you exhale, you're gonna draw your belly up and in and roll the back up, roll your shoulders. Ah, a little forward fold there to kind of get everything reset. Really nice. Stretch up for me. You're gonna take your left wrist in your right hand and stretch over. And there's that side bend. Simple stretches today, really just to get us up and moving together. nothing really earth shattering. It should just feel nice. We'll be passing by. And then come on down. We'll do that one more time. Give it a big stretch up. Hold on to one wrist. Pull up and over. And then come on up, up and over to the other side. Good. And then good things always come in threes. So let's do it one more time. Take a big inhale up. Stretch up, up and over with one wrist. Nice. Up and over, really nice. Come on down. Relax your shoulders. Good. Hey, shake your shoulders a little bit. You're gonna use your chair or the floor for this. So if you have a chair, that's great. And if you wanna just use the floor, that's totally fine. But we're gonna get into your hamstrings. Right, again, kind of feeling through all of these motions today. So here's my chair. You're gonna take your right leg, just set it up on the chair. So if you have a totally high chair, maybe use the floor. Also, if you have sensitive hamstrings or any low back strain, the floor is great. But you're gonna set your heel of your right foot down on the floor so we can hinge back. Again, if you want that higher surface, you could use your chair to do this. I just like everybody to square off your hips. Take a moment, take that mindful moment to roll the hips forward. And then you're gonna hinge like a nice flat plank-like position in your upper body to stretch the hamstrings. Ugh. Now, if you have your hand foot on the floor, you're gonna take your hand, cross it over. You'll probably get to the outside thigh here as you stretch back, right? If you have your foot on the chair, you might be able to get a little bit farther down, a little bit farther wide with the hand, and we just take that stretching out of the outside of your hip. We're gonna take a couple of breaths here just to slow down. Let's take one more there, balance here, yeah. And then come on up. Now, you're gonna leave your foot exactly where it is. So if you're on the floor, it looks like this. You're gonna turn and externally rotate through that front right leg, okay? And you're gonna rotate over towards it. If you have your foot up on your chair, you're gonna do the same thing. Right leg up, you're just gonna rotate out a little bit. So now it becomes a little bit more of an inner thigh stretch. And then we're gonna take a couple breaths here. So you find your position. I'm gonna give you about 30 seconds to stay and hold, right? So again, either foot is on the floor, you're rotated towards that outside leg, the nice externally rotated other leg, or same on the chair. You rotate away. This is a stretch we did a lot on the, we used to do spin all the time. We would do it on the spin bike. You should feel that subtle shift of that inner thigh stretch. And you also feel that hum of your breath starting to build nice and steady. Good, slowly bring yourself up. Oh, shake out that leg. Go ahead and bring your leg off. Shake the legs a little bit, let it go. We're gonna get to the other side. So now we're using other leg on the floor, up on your chair. But take that moment to rotate the hips forward, right? So shoulders, hips in alignment. And then you're gonna hinge forward. So upper body should feel like you were in a plank on the floor. I want you to feel that long axial elongation that that stretch out of the hips gives you. Yeah. And then when you're ready, you're gonna take that little turn towards your outside leg. So again, if you have your leg up on the chair, it's gonna give you a little bit more space to move. Your foot is on the floor. You're probably gonna land somewhere around your upper thigh or your knee, but it's that subtle shift over of your opposite shoulder. Now, how deep is your breath here? Take a nice inhale and exhale. Draw the belly in, let it go a little bit deeper. Good. Come on back to the center. All right. Shake the shoulders a little bit. Leave your front foot where it is. Again, either out in front of you. You're going to turn and externally rotate that other leg and then shift your body to the other side. All right. So it's a little inner thigh shift away. If your foot is on your chair, you're going to do the same thing. Externally rotate and then just sit back. Take this about 30 seconds. Have a big stretch on the inside of my thigh here. Weights on the outside of your leg. You can always use your chair to balance as well. Use the wall, use your countertop. A nice long static hold that really elongates the inside of your thigh. One more breath here. Take a nice inhale. Exhale, let it go. And then come on up. Nice. Hey, carefully, gently bring that leg off. Shake him out a little bit. And then grab your band or your towel or your yoga strap again. I'm going to take that one more set from the top. Now that your legs are a little bit looser, before we get into your hips a little bit more, I'd like you to take, remember that twist we did side to side? And twist. You want to do this free arm too, you're welcome to. This feels good to loosen up a little bit after that static hold. Good. All right, couple more. Remember to release that opposite leg as you twist. And now we're going to go for that sundial. So you're going to drop your arms down and to the right, up and over to the left, or vice versa. But bend your knees there. Give yourself that little forward fold. And then that stretch to the other side. Good, let's go to the other way. Let that feel so nice and different than the last time you were here. Rotate. Let's go one more there, up and over. Oof. Good, land yourself back in the center and set your strap down. Good, you're gonna have a seat in your chair here. We're gonna have our last hip stretches. So I'm gonna drop that camera down just a little bit. All right, so come to the edge of your chair. I want you to kind of perch on the edge of your chair and extend your left leg out. So externally rotate your left leg, and then you're gonna internally rotate your right leg. So you kind of end up sideways on your chair. Give it back to your chair. You're gonna use that for a little stretch here, hold. We're gonna work a side bend. So lift up and over. Cool. And then your inhale is gonna bring you back. And as you do this, you're gonna repeat. I want you to feel a bigger stretch in your hip flexor, in that front of your hip. Every time you flex over to your left side. Inhale. Exhale, come up and over. One more there. Inhale, stretch up. Let your right leg stay really heavy down towards the floor. Come on up. Hold that for a moment. Check it out. Yeah, let's go to the other side. Sit back. Simple, but it feels good. You're going to externally rotate through your right leg now. Little internal rotation through your left side, but find yourself kind of perched on the edge. And you can walk this leg back as far as it feels like you can get that stretch through your left hip flexor. Now let's add in your side bend, lift up, and then up and over. Inhale, stretch tall, stack the shoulders and your hips. And exhale, come up and over. Inhale, let's do that two more times. So feeling that work in opposition, right? Left arm coming up and over. Right side getting heavy, but left side getting longer. One more time, lift up. Ever happened to me? Come on back to the center. Just pause for a moment. Let that leg hang down low. Let me give it a little push down, open up the hip. Yeah. And then come on back to the center. Yeah, we're going to continue with that side bend. So give yourself nice wide base. It could be like wide. It could be regular seated position, but I want you to feel stable here. You're going to take your right, left hand to the base of your chair and then lift up and over. And we're going to move with your breath here. Lift up and over. Just a little bit of a flow here to finish. Lift one side to the other side. And again, tapping into the breath. That's kind of really what we're working here. You're going to get a stretch through either side, but I'd like you to feel that conscious movement of your breath. Inhale. Exhale over. How about one more time each side? Feeling length and movement through the waistline. Relaxation through the shoulder and the jaw. Good. And then come on down. You're going to rotate back towards your left side. So left foot's going to externally rotate. You're going to come into that kind of hip flexor, quad stretch again. Just make sure that both sit bones are pretty heavy into the carriage. You're going to rotate her into your chair. You're going to lift your outside right arm up. And then this time it's going to stretch out in front of you. Right, but give me a strong right arm like someone was pulling you away. I'm gonna take a twist here. You're gonna exhale, twist towards the back of your chair. And then inhale, stretch, big open, look back. Exhale, twist. Inhale, open. Inhale, open. Let's do that one more time. Exhale, twist. Inhale, stretch open. Just stay for a moment. Come on down, roll your shoulders. Good job. Hey, come on back. Yeah, and let's go to the other side. You're gonna drop your opposite knee down. So externally rotate through your left side. Rotate your right leg so it's down, or your left leg so it's down. Right side is your base, left side is getting a stretch. And then give me your left arm up, and then left arm straight away in front of you. So notice the stack of your shoulders and your hips. Exhale, twist and rotate. Inhale, open. Exhale, twist, rotate. Exhale, twist. Let's do that two more times. Inhale, open. One more time. Stretch, reach, get all that space to the chest. Exhale, twist, and you're going to land on that open phase. Reach, open, open. Exhale, settle that hand down. Relax your shoulders. Gently bring your leg back in. And set yourself up right in the center. You can always use your chair to recline back in this. So we're going to take a quick figure four stretch. Really important to get into your hips here. So you know the drill, right? You can take your leg up a little bit higher, but cross your ankle over. Keep it a nice neutral ankle over your thigh. If you're feeling it today, you can always drop it into that full figure four stretch. But just take a moment, actually 38 moments here. We're going to be here about 40 seconds, 38 more seconds from here. Just to let your hip open gently. There's also an option if you're in that figure four stretch where your leg is dropping a little bit, you're welcome to add a twist towards that front thigh. Oh, wiggle the jaw a little bit, like feel all that movement into your spine. Rotate back, really nice. Ah, very gently take this leg off and then replace it with your other side. So again, either holding in this a little bit higher figure four stretch, just making sure your your ankle is in a neutral position. It's not sickling. Or if you want to drop into that full figure four. And then if you're in that figure four, you're welcome to add a twist towards that front thigh. Just stay and breathe for a moment. You feel a nice, steady, but soft breath. On back. Unwind the spine just a little bit. Shake the shoulders, relax a little bit. Set your feet just flat on the floor for me. And you can slouch back in your chair. Don't worry about your posture here. You can sit up tall if that feels good. You can even sit on the floor, crisscross applesauce if you'd like. I'm gonna take a couple breaths here just to settle in. So roll your shoulders, just like we started. Roll your shoulders back. And then roll your shoulders forward. Yeah, and then let your shoulders settle somewhere in between those two extremes. And then you're gonna take that internal rotation. So shoulders roll forward. Almost think like your elbows are rolling out wide. And then exhale, you're gonna open your chest, roll your elbows and your shoulder blades back together. Do that two more times. Roll in like you are caving your chest. And then roll wide open. Shoulder blades together. Yes, one more time. Inhale, cave the chest. Even go into a little flexion with the spine there if that feels good. And open wide. Let the shoulder blades pull together, like magnetically pull back. Give it a little strength. And then to settle in, I'd like you to find some place that's in between those two places, right? Push up the shoulders. Not rolling forward, not rolling back, not up, not down, but wherever your shoulders land after all that movement. Your hands to either thighs or even onto your belly. Take a soft belly breath here. So you're gonna inhale, open the rib cage nice and wide. Exhale, let it go. Maybe there's a close of the eyes just to settle in. There's really nothing more to look at here. Just taking a couple breaths together. So feel how after those really simple movements, nothing earth-shattering, nothing crazy different, but some really awesome movements to open your joints, open your muscles. Slow down the breath. Those sequence of exercises strung together can change your feeling in your mind, in your body, can change your trajectory for the rest of the afternoon or whenever you watch this back, right? So enjoy that space that you built in your muscles, in your joints, your mind. And we'll take that out. Have a good rest of your time. It's Wednesday afternoon, or again, whenever you watch it back, it's a great thing to do before you go to bed. Calm everything down, get some movement in for the evening, or start with it, movement in the morning. But feel this area of calm and space that we just built together. And I always thank you for your time and space and effort together. You guys always grateful for this time together. So continue this really calm, relaxed breath. I'm gonna encourage you to stay here for as long as you have time for. I'm gonna turn off the video, but I'm gonna keep the music going for just a little bit. So enjoy it. Enjoy your calm breath. I certainly enjoyed our time together. Thank you very, very much. I'll see you very soon.